a lot of the candidates that we're working with, we're cultivating, recruiting, they come from, especially from CUNY, they come from these communities, right? Which means some of them actually had people who like passed away due to the pandemic, right? Like mothers, fathers, aunts, uncles, grandfathers. So for us to like be tone deaf and not acknowledge that or not start there, right? Like while we want them to come and teach, yes, for the sake of our students, like you can't give something that you don't have. And so, or you can't pour from a cup that's empty. So like we need to do some like authentic and genuine love up on them, wrap our arms around them, make sure that they feel supported before we ask them to go help students to like, you know, sort of live out their mission and realize who they are. It's like, look, let's just take a second. Let's take a breather and get you to exhale. Let's give you a space, right? We have these things, these affinity groups where folks are able to just be able to talk and be their authentic self. And so that is also a big part of it, a part of our recruitment. Again, like I said, it's not about just the numerical growth or just about the numbers, right? It's about people, right?
You know, to speak to what you're talking about, community, I feel like we're just so conditioned to believe in this whole lone wolf mentality that we have to do everything by myself. You always hear, yeah, I did it from the ground up by myself, by myself, by myself. But why are we so proud of doing everything by ourselves when if there's support, there's nothing wrong with asking for help. So I feel like us being able to extend that helping hand and then people accepting it is much more than they can ever imagine, because once they actually take that help, they realize, wait, why was I even trying to do all this by myself in the beginning?
Yeah.
This dude could charge a masterclass on this right now if he wanted to.